It looks like we might not actually be getting the next DLC as soon as we thought. However, there is some really good news, and that good news being the next DLC may be way bigger than we initially thought. This is coming from Yan. He tweeted about the nightclub update last night. He said, "So I heard back about the nightclub's update for GTA Online. Unfortunately, it's been pushed back to a later month, but the good news is it's fairly big. Heard something about how they took the content of two updates and put it into the single one." Now, there's a lot to break down in that tweet. Obviously, the most notable part being the DLC may not be coming out in June. But the fact that they seem to be combining two DLCs into one, that is also very interesting. We'll talk about the release date part first. I'm sure there's going to be the people that say nothing can get delayed if it's not been officially announced. And you're right, but this is what Rockstar do. They never announce anything. They're always so secretive. So we kind of have to rely on these leakers and people who know people at Rockstar that give them information, like Yan. So for all intents and purposes, I'm going to say it was delayed, even though it wasn't officially announced. Now, he does say a later month. And I do just want to point out that a later month does not mean 1 month later. I'm sure Yan used that wording just so nothing could come back to him. That's a pretty general, pretty broad time period. With that being said, though, I don't see Rockstar releasing this too late into summer. They definitely want to release this sooner to get people interested into GTA Online before maybe some other big games come out. Also, we know officially, the one thing we know officially, Rockstar said the new music is coming out in the summer. So that's anytime after June 21st. So something definitely is happening this summer. We just, I guess, don't know precisely when it will come out. One thing that I could see happening, just because it makes total sense if they want people to get back into playing GTA Online, is Rockstar doing double money on heists for a couple of weeks. So for instance, next week we're going to get, hopefully, the Jester Classic with the new Transform races. Next week should be end of this drip feed we've been going through, and hopefully they release the Jester Classic with those new races. Once that's done, then let's say the following week they start this double money on heists, and they could do this for 4 straight weeks. They could start the first week with the old heists, you know, for that week all the old heists get double money, and then for the next week, part one of the Doomsday heist gets double money. The following week, part two gets double money, and then the final week, part four or three, gets double money. That pretty much takes you all the way through June, and I would imagine double money on the Doomsday heist, or just heist in general, would get a lot of people back into the game, and it would make sense for Rockstar because summer's out. They want people to get back into the game. They want people to have some money for the next DLC. They want people interested in the game again, and what better way to do that than to have probably the most fun missions in the game double money right as school lets out. And this isn't really coming out of anywhere. A couple of weeks ago, there was an incident with Rockstar where they accidentally turned double money on for Doomsday heists. So that's another reason why I believe that whole situation could happen and is likely to happen. Now, as for the two updates in one comment, it actually makes sense if they do that this year, especially with Red Dead Redemption 2 coming out. Imagine last year, instead of them releasing Gun Running in June and Smuggler's Run in, I want to say, September? Could be wrong on the exact month, but instead of releasing them apart, what if they combine them and release them in July? That is what looks like is happening here. And the reason that makes sense for this year is because Red Dead 2 comes out in October, and I'm sure Rockstar don't want any GTA Online content to be coming out while Red Dead 2 is releasing. So if they were to do these two updates in one, and let's say release it in July, it would probably have enough drip-fed content to go all the way up till the release of Red Dead 2. This also makes sense as to why the QA Beta 3 branch was updated. I'm guessing they added that to test this other part of this update. Like, they had the regular QA Beta stuff for the nightclub DLC, but then they had this QA Beta 3 for whatever this other part of the DLC is. And as for speculation on what that other part could be, there was the business consolidation leak that Yan talked about a couple months ago. That could be a part of this. it could just be another DLC with a bunch of cars and some new properties and perhaps some new missions. You guys in the comment section can definitely let me know what you think would go good with some sort of nightclub DLC. I don't really want to speculate too much on that end. But that is an update for the next DLC in GTA Online. Let me know your thoughts. I know, again, nothing was officially announced, so technically it can't be delayed, but I guess internally it was delayed, so we may not be getting it in June, but if they do the double money on heist, I think we'll all be fine with that if we get this DLC in July. Thank you all for watching, though. Please drop the video a like if you did enjoy. Subscribe for more awesome GTA content and to be updated on any other news regarding the next DLCs. But as always, I will see you guys in the next one.